Sir, I rise to speak on the budget and in support of my cut motions against the government. Sir, regarding any budget in the world, in the country, Mahatma Gandhi gave a talisman. He had said that when you do something, think of the face of the poorest man that you know and consider whether your step will do anything to wipe off the tear from that man. Now, in that criterion laid down by Mahatma Gandhi, this budget fails because it has not given any sop to the poor, to the migrant labor, to the agricultural laborers, the jobless factory workers. That's why I think this budget is not good for the country. Sir, the finance minister has gone to have a lunch. I don't deny her, but it would be good if she was here. There are Anurag Singh Thakur from Himachal, who's her deputy, is here. He is mainly the Hindi translator. I don't know whether he decides on policy issues. Sir, what I want to say at this stage,
please avoid such observations, please. It is some. Yes, I do agree. I do agree. He is a responsible minister in the Council of Ministers. Please. Yes. It should be expensive, please.
Sir, if I may say that I saw a film by Gurinder Chadha, an English director. The film was known, Bend It Like Beckham. Now this budget will be called Spend It Like Sitaraman. She has spent money willfully in a profligate manner without thinking of the fiscal consequences. I shall also say, I looked up the who's who of the Rajya Sabha, Nirmala Sitaraman. She is MA in economics from Sita Lakshmi Ramaswamy College in Tiruchirappalli. She is MPhil from Jawaharlal Nehru University. But I want to add one degree to her. It will be called OLX. She is part of the OLX which sells everything. She is the master of selling off the family silver, the assets. I'll go into disinvestment later. Sir, let me go into the details of the budget. The total budget is of the value of rupees 34.83 lakh crores. It is the same as last year, which was 34.50 lakh crores. So expenditure boost has not been there. Sir, the fiscal deficit is 15.06 lakh crore last year, this year, that is 6.8% of GDP, as compared to 9.5% of GDP. I was in this house when Mr. Jaitley used to give his speech as finance minister. He said, we promise that fiscal deficit will be brought within 3%. Of GDP. Now, fiscal deficit had gone to 9.5% last year. What does it mean? It means that this will lead to inflation and price rise, which is already happening. Fiscal prudence has been thrown out of the window. And Mrs. Sitaraman said, spend it like Sitaraman. She said, I spent and spent and spent. That's how the budget deficit went so high. Sir, I want to mention That's a good thing. That 35,000 crores has been given for vaccines. But may I mention in this house that the government did not lockdown at the proper time. Mr. Modi was busy with Trump and with unseating the government in Madhya Pradesh. That's why lockdown was declared 4 days after it should have been declared. It spread. Then the migrant labor, they were given no time to go to their homes. And you have seen the pictures shown on Barkhadat's TV. Migrant laborers walking home with their luggage on their head, holding their child and their wife by the hand, dying on the wayside. This is another cruelty by the present government. Earlier cruelty was demonetization, where people died standing in queue. This neglect to migrant labor, declaring lockdown without giving notice to people, was another act of cruelty. Our Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee has called the Prime Minister a cruel person. Sir, if I may go into this, that where does the government get the money? If you see, the government is getting most of the money from borrowing. If you see the budget at a glance, you will see that rupee comes from borrowings and other liabilities, 36 paise per rupee. And total tax is much less. So what are they doing? They are borrowing to sustain the budget. And they have not been able to raise revenue sufficiently. And they are depending on disinvestment. Sir, out of this expenditure, 34.83 lakh crores, 1.75 lakh crores will come out of disinvestment. So Mrs. Sitaraman may call herself something. You know, there are films in Hollywood called Avenger, Terminator. I should call her the great dismantler. She is dismantling the whole edifice of the public sector. Jawaharlal Nehru, in industrial policy resolution in 1956, said public sector will occupy the commanding heights of the economy. This government wants to take the public sector to the bottom of the economy. That is the most unfortunate, that public assets built over time and through the labor and money of our poor people will be sold to cronies of the government. This is the worst form of crony capitalism. You know, sir, some airports have been sold, 6 airports. You know who they have gone to? All of them gone to one family called the Adani. If this is not crony capitalism, what is crony capitalism, sir? Will you tell me? Sir, see, what are the companies that are being sold? What are the companies that are being sold? Sir, you know what is the condition in BSNL. You know, now on the list, on the anvil, Air India, Bharat Petroleum, Shipping Corporation, Container Corporation of India, CONCOR, LIC, sir, so every government will roll up its sleeves and then they are going to sell, sir, two public sector banks, one public sector insurance company. Mrs. Sitaraman can go to her party and say, see, you wanted to dismantle Nehru, you are not able to. I have dismantled the public sector. You wanted to dismantle anything built by Indira Gandhi, she nationalize the banks. She nationalized general insurance. I am selling to public sector banks. I am selling one insurance companies. This wanton privatization, selling of the family silver. And what else they are doing is more dangerous. They are monetizing all the assets of public sector, which means any land with the public sector that will be sold to fund this budget. You know that the assets of National Highway Authority of India, they will be monetized. All the roads that will be given to private parties. You know the distribution network formed by Power Grid Corporation of India, that will be given to private sector. What remains of the public sector that was assiduously built from Nehru's time? Bajpayee did not dismantle it. This government under Narendra Modi and under Mrs. Sitaraman is doing that, dismantling the whole of the public sector. So let me discuss a little about the budget. In fact, there is nothing to discuss about the budget. The economy had contracted by 7.4%. Now there is a pandit who's the chief economic advisor. He has said that we are for a, his name is Subra, his name is, I'll tell you. He's a pandit. He said that man, the CA, he said that we are in the midst of a V-shaped curve. That is, the curve has gone down like this. It will show rise from now on. This will happen. His name is Krishnamurthy Subramaniam. He's a Tamilian, sir. And he's promising all things to people, that economy will come out of this rut. You know, sir, that the economy is contracted by minus 7.4%. Now, how they propose to revive it? They say that we are spending big on infrastructure. Now, will that immediately solve the problem? It will not, because infrastructure projects take a long time in coming up. So how will it fund the liquidity in the economy? And you see infrastructure, that Chamoli hydroelectric power station that was being built by...
One second. The minister would like to intervene just for a second. Then if he is yielding, let the minister...
Sir, he is a senior leader. He just called the chief economic advisor first as a Brahmin, then as a Tamilian.
Oh, no, he never said Brahmin.
He said that. It is on record, kindly.
Then it will be.
Sir,
then it will
be. And okay. Then Tamilian. Sir, both should not go. That's all I have to request you. Rest you can criticize.
Pandit is a bad word.
Yes, Saugodrai ji.
Pandit is a bad word.
Tamilian no problem, but another thing I do agree. Yes.
Sir, so this...
Tamilian, Keralite, Bihari, Madhya Pradesh, is representing particular state, that's all.
Sir.
No, the other observation, definitely it will be. Definitely.
This is the BJP stratagem on the floor that disturb those who are speaking against the government. Sometimes Nishikant Dubey, sometimes Ravi Shankar Prasad will be put to the job. It doesn't really matter. It really doesn't matter. Sir, if I may say that Mrs. Sitaraman, during this lockdown, announced two fiscal stimulus. All over the world, economists told him. Amartya Sen, Abhijit Binayak Banerjee, both Nobel laureates, they told him that if you want to give a fiscal stimulus, put some money in the hands of the migrant labor. They suggested a figure, 10,000 rupees. The cruel government did not do it. He said, we'll give help to the economy, to the MSME, etc., etc. They refused to give the fiscal stimulus, as a result of which the economy did not revive at all. This year, They are giving more money for capex, that is capital expenditure, rupees 5.54 lakh crores. It's a good thing if assets get built up by that money, but will it take us out of the rut that we are in? I'll say this, that two steps are good. The whole banking system has collapsed. You may be knowing, sir. Crony capitalists have taken away the money. Vijay Mallya, Nirav Modi, and Mehul Choksi have still not been arrested. They have still not been their cronies of the you know who. They have not been arrested. The total NPA of bank amount to 14 lakh crores. Now they are creating a bad bank. They call it asset reconstruction and asset management company. So to the bad bank, all these accounts will be shifted. Will a bad bank solve the problem? Many people say that they will not, because there are asset reconstruction companies in the private sector now. They are not being able to solve the problem. What if the government suddenly creates a bad bank? The other thing, they are not a bad step. They are creating a development finance institution. For the big infrastructure project, money is necessary, so they are creating that. Sir, this I have already said, that this asset monetization and privatization of non-strategic PSU will create havoc in the economy. Now, they are constantly talking about startups. Startup, stand up, sit down, Hello India, Padho India. Ye sab karta hai. So startup is not successful in this country. And then they say startups will get a year more to claim tax holiday and an additional year of capital gains tax exemption. I want to have a statement from the government as to what the success of the startup is. So the main thing, I'll tell you, at this stage of the economy was to put money in the hands of the people to boost demand. This is a simple matter. You increase liquidity in the economy, people will buy things, then economy will come up. They have not, and that could be done through tax cuts for the middle class. Everybody was expecting that this budget would give tax cuts for the poor. They did not. They're very cruel, sir. They know middle class you are expecting, we won't give you. Oh, kisans, you are agitating, we won't agree to your demand. We have got 303, all this silent majority from our great cow belt of India. They will not let you do that. So that is what is happening. They did not give the steps. Take this step, sir. So they have given minor relief. And if you see the budget carefully, income tax certain procedures have been simplified. No income tax cut. Excise, they cannot do anything. That will be under GST. So she has tinkered with customs, increasing the price of certain things. But actually what has happened ultimately is that all, despite all this stall talk, if you look at the flagship schemes, you look at NREGA. Last year, NREGS is the biggest employment creator, must be even in Kollam. Sir, last year budget estimate was, total revised estimate was 1,11,500. This year it has been cut to 73,000. And they've said that they are giving more money for health. You know how? It's by a turn of, by a trick. They have added health to Jal Jeevan Mission, that is rural drinking water supply, and say we are giving 2,23,000 crores
Savadraji,
for
please.
Health and well-being. It's a peculiar type of explanation.
Yes, one
sir.
More speaker from your party, so kindly.
Sir,
One more speaker from your party, so kindly try to conclude.
I'll speak. I'll leave.
No, sir, yeah.
No speaker.
All I want to say is that on the flagship programs, money has come down. Even the PM Kisan Samman Nidhi, the money has been reduced. So what have they done? They have borrowed and borrowed. Nirmala Sitharaman has spent and spent. The economy is not still showing an upturn. What will happen to this country, sir? I'll give you some solid advice that we got from the IMF. You know, sir, Geeta Gopinath, she is from Kerala. Geeta gave advice. This IMF advice, they said, which is why IMF is calling for a synchronized investment in green and digital infrastructure as the pandemic starts to come under control. Sir, Geeta was also advising our Pinarayi Vijayan for some time. Now she has gone back to IMF full time. She has also said, governments must put in place public investment. Listen to this. When this government is selling everything, IMF is saying, International Monetary Fund, American Control Organization, they are saying, government must put in place public investment as well as incentives for private investment that support low carbon and climate resilient growth. This could be efficient mass transit system, smart electricity grids, or phasing out harmful subsidies. But listen to this, sir. Of course, green and digital investment must also include support for workers as they transition from shrinking to expanding sectors, increased investment in training, reskilling, and high quality education will be pivotal to unlocking the potential of a green and digital economy. Does this budget speak about a green and digital economy, which is the need of the hour? Sir, also? No, I'm not. He is very happy that Geeta Gopinath praised the farm laws. When it's a toss up between Geeta Gopinath and the farmers on the Delhi borders, I'm with the farmers. When it's a toss up between Geeta Gopinath and this government, I'm with Geeta Gopinath. My choice is quite simple, sir.
Sir, thank Geeta, you. Please.
Sir, sir, Geeta has also said this. Sir, you know that during this year of the pandemic, China has grown by, we have contracted by 7.4%. China has been successful in containing the pandemic. They grew at 2.3%. At least they are able to control the pandemic. And in this situation, they grew by 2.3%. We have not been able to take that example. Sir, I would ask this government that at this stage, let them make friends with the country. The Prime Minister was mentioning triple talaq, this, all these are divisive agendas. Let the government not divide the country anymore. Let the government do something really to lift the poor, the marginal farmer, the migrant worker, out of their poverty. Let the government look at West Bengal, how well the Chief Minister has implemented Kanyasri, which benefited 69 lakh girls, Shobuj Sathi, where 84 lakh students were given cycles, Swastha Sathi, which is touching 10 crore people in the country. Let them learn. Let them take a leaf out of West Bengal's book and lift the country out of this morass which their wrong politics and economics has taken the country.
Thank you,
sir. Welcome.